Dear students, today we are going to see the next important food crops, namely grapes. Actually, grape cultivation is one of the most remunerative farming enterprises in India. Sasruda Samhita, Charaka Samhita, written during 1356 to 1220 BC, mentions about the medicinal properties of the grapes, indicating its age-old grape cultivation. Native species resembling Vitis lareata and Vitis palmata grow wild in the northwestern Himalayan foothills. Cultivated grapes are believed to have been introduced into north of India by the Persian invaders in 1300 AD. Grape was introduced into the south, especially in Salem and Madurai districts of Tamil Nadu, by the Christian missionaries around 1832 AD. Later, it spread to different parts of the country. The fruit contains about 20% of sugar in easily digestible form, besides being rich in calcium and phosphorus. World over, it is grown mainly for the wine making, nearly 82% of the total production. Raisin making about 10%, and the balance, namely 8%, goes for table purpose. In India, however, it is mostly consumed as fresh fruit, and only a limited quantity is utilized for the production of liquor, dry fruits like raisin, etc. Now we will see the climate and soil requirement of grapes. It is grown in subtropical and tropical conditions of India. Sandy to clayey and loamy soils with good drainage and irrigation facility is suitable for the cultivation of grapes. Soils having pH value from 6.5 to 7.5 are most suitable for grape cultivation. In its natural habitat, the crop bears fruit during the hot and dry period and undergoes dormancy during the period of severe cold. It tolerates frost during the rusting stage, but is very susceptible during growing period. Temperature ranging from 15 to 35 degree C is ideal for shoot growth and normal physiological processes of the grape vine. Locations where annual rainfall does not exceed 900 mm are most ideal for its cultivation. Humidity associated with the rains during flowering and fruit ripening is not favorable and invites the attack of fungal diseases. Vegetative growth takes place in the spring season. Consequently, the fruiting is only once in a year during the summer months. Varieties. Actually, grapes, which belongs to the genus Vitis, belonging to the family Vitaceae, is a temperate crop which has got adapted to subtropical climate of peninsular India, but even now we are growing under tropical conditions also. The varieties are classified based on three criteria. One is region-wise varieties, that is the most preferred varieties in different region. First region is northern region or northern India region, which comprises of states like Haryana, Punjab, Delhi, western Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan. These regions prefer the varieties like Thompson seedless, Perlet, Beauty seedless, Anabi Shahi, Black Pandari Sahib, Vadam Cross, Pusa seedless, Har, Black Muscat, Early Muscat, Bangipot, Cardinal and Chiron. The second region, which consists of the peninsular India comprising of the states like Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, North Karnataka, these regions prefer the varieties like Anabi Shahi, Thompson seedless, Chima Sahib, Bandari Sahib, Gulabi, Bokri, Kali Sahipi, Sonaka and Dasa Ganesh, which is a clone of the Thompson seedless variety. The region 3, which also within the peninsular India comprising of states like South Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, here the varieties like Bokri, Anab Shahi, Gulabi, Bangalore Blue, Black Chamba, Convan Large Black, Angur Karan, Typhi Rosalvi, Corona Rosin, Queen of Wainat, Kandari, Black Prince, Muscat, Pachatracha are much preferred varieties. Then second classification is commercial varieties utilized for specific purposes. So based on this, first let us see varieties suitable for table purposes. That is as a desert variety. Varieties like Anab Shahi, Bangalore Blue, Beauty Seedless, Bokri, that is our Pachataracha, Kima Sahib, Delight, Gulabi, Himrod, Bandari Sahib, Berlet, Selection 94, Pusa Seedless and Thompson Seedless are some of the varieties coming under this category. Raisin grapes, that is those varieties which are exclusively used for the raisin making. Varieties like Thompson Seedless and Arkavadi are much suitable for raisin grapes. Then wine grapes. Here Bangalore Blue, Thompson Seedless and Arka Kanjan are much preferred for wine production. Then the third category of classification is based on color and seeds. Here we can say first one is the colored seeded grapes. Here Bangalore Blue and Gulabi are some of the examples are varieties coming under colored seeded group. Next one is colored seedless. Here Beauty Seedless and Sarat Seedless are some of the varieties coming under this category. Third one is the wild seeded type. Here Anab Shahi, Dilgush, which is a clone of Anab Shahi, are represented under this group. Last one is the white seedless, varieties like Perlet, Pusa Seedless, Thompson Seedless and its clones are coming under this category. Next we will see the propagation methods. Grapes are multiplied mainly by the rooting of hardwood cuttings. Well matured canes obtained in September-October are selected. Cuttings of 4 nodes each with a thickness of 8 to 10 millimeter are made from the selected canes. The fresh cuttings are soaked in running water for 24 hours to leach out the water soluble rooting inhibitors. The basal parts of the cuttings are then dipped in a solution of IBA 2000 ppm for 5 minutes before planting, which will promote good rooting. Soil application of chloropyrifos at the rate of 0.1% is recommended to prevent the termite attack. Recently, use of rootstocks to overcome the high pH and saline resistance are nowadays available. Coming to the land preparation, land is tilled and laid into plots of 120 meter into 180 meter separated by 3 meter wide rows. Trenches of 75 cm width, 75 cm depth and 118 meter length in a north-south direction with a gap of 3 meter between trenches are opened with the heavy machinery. They are closed with the topsoil up to a height of 45 cm after 15 days exposure to the sun. The remaining gap is filled with mixture of soil, cattle manure, single superphosphate, sulphate of potash and micronutrients. Now we will see the spacing requirement. Spacing generally varies with the varieties and soil fertility. For vigorous varieties, it is 6 into 3 meter spacing or 4 into 3 meter and 3 into 3 meter or 3 into 2 meter for less vigorous varieties. Planting method. Grapevines are usually planted in pits. The depth may vary from 60 to 90 centimeter depending upon the soil type. Wider spacing, that is 1.2 into 1.2 meter is required in case of vigorous varieties like Anab Shahi and Bangalore Blue. A little less than 1 meter, that is 0.90 into 0.90 centimeter is required in case of varieties like Thompson Seedless, Perlet, Beauty Seedless. In central Maharashtra and northern parts of Karnataka, the spacing adopted for Thompson Seedless and its mutant is 1.8 into 2.4 meter. The pits need to be opened about a month before planting. The best time for planting is February-March in North India, November-January in Peninsular India. In Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, it is usually planted during December-January due to the fact that rains last to the end of November. Growth of the plant starts about 10 to 15 days after planting. After 1 month of planting, the young plants need staking and training. Now we will see the aftercare requirement of grapes. Irrigation, it is normally provided once in every 3 days in newly planted vineyards by allowing water into the small circular basin of 15 cm radius. With the increase in growth rate, the size of the basin increases to a radius of 2 meter. In the case of drip irrigation, in the beginning, one emitter is placed at the base of the vine, two and then four, which are shifted to about 30 to 40 centimeter away from the stem, depending upon the variety and spacing and growth of the vines. Training and pruning. This is the very important operation as far as grape is concerned. Many training systems are in work in India, but the most popular are bower system, telephone system and flat roof gable system. First, we will see the bower system. As the shoots start growing from the newly planted rooted cuttings in the main field, only the best shooting, shoot growing vertically is allowed to grow along the stake provided. In later years, each hardwood vine is pruned at the wire position and can branches spread on both directions. In the case of telephone system, T trellis is used wherein with three top wires and T shaped supports, the trellis look like a telephone poles. Next is flat roof gable system. Combining the advantage of bower and the extended Y systems and eliminating their disadvantages, and interconnected Y trellis forming a flat roof gable is being adopted. This system is particularly followed for vigorous varieties like or those varieties grafted on the rootstocks. The bunches are protected from direct sunlight and well exposed to sprays of pesticides. The clusters hang within the reach of the worker of an average height. Owing to these advantages, this system is gaining popularity among the growers in Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. Next, we will see the pruning requirement of grapes. The prevailing pruning practices in India can be broadly grouped into three categories. One is single pruning, single cropping. This system is prevalent in North India. Since only one growing season is available there, grape vines are pruned with the onset of spring or during late winter, mostly January, February months. Floral differentiation on the current season shoots and the fruit set takes place simultaneously. If all the bearing shoots are retained on the vine and pruned in the next winter for fruiting, the fruiting wood multiplies faster and the vine canopy becomes denser year after year, leading to a barrenness within just 3 to 4 years. In order to regulate the vine canopy and extend its productive lifespan, half of the matured shoots are pruned for fruiting and the other half are pruned for renewing the spurs to give rise to the shoots that develop into fruiting canes for the next year. Alternatively, the fruiting canes are pruned back to renewable spurs and the matured shoots developed from the previous spurs are pruned to fruiting canes year after year. The second one is called double pruning, single cropping. This system is predominantly followed in Maharashtra, North India, Karnataka in case of Thompson seedless and Andhra Pradesh on Thompson seedless and Anabishagi grapes. After harvest in summer, the vines are forced to undergo rest for 2 months. During which period, water is withheld to help concentrate the reserves in the mature parts of the vine. All the fruiting canes are pruned back to spurs, retaining only one basal node. This is called back pruning or foundation pruning or summer pruning. Buds on the shoots growing from these spurs differentiate into floral primordial and the shoots mature in about 5 months. These mature shoots are pruned for fruiting before the onset of winter, that is September-October. This pruning is called forward pruning or fruit pruning or winter pruning. All the mature shoots are subjected to fruit pruning. Thus, in this system of pruning, a cycle of two prunings resulting in one crop is practiced. The last one is double pruning, double cropping. This system is in work for Anabishagi and Bangalore blue grapes in Karnataka and for Anabishagi, Bokri, Gulabi in Tamil Nadu. Mature shoots are pruned to canes of 7 to 8 buds after harvesting the crop in summer. The mature shoots arising from these 3 to 4 buds along with the spurs are pruned for fruiting canes in the next winter. In the Madurai region and other parts of Tamil Nadu, pruning is done during November-December for summer crop, harvested during March-April and during May-June for the second crop harvested during August-September. In South Kerala, the forward pruning is done during October-November for summer crop harvested during February-March and during April-May for the second crop harvested during July-August. In Bangalore blue, only forward pruning is practiced. time of pruning could be any time of the year except in December. In this variety, the crop is harvested about 5 months after pruning. As a result, 5 crops are harvested in 2 years and the crop is harvested almost throughout the year. Next, we will see the importance of shoot pinching. Shoot pinching is mainly done to regulate the growth and provide better ventilation and light interception into the vine canopy. Shoot pinching is done during the growth as well as fruiting seasons in South India, but only during the fruiting season in Northern India. Water, nutrient and weed management. These are all very important for grapes. First, we will see the irrigation. Heavy irrigation is provided soon after pruning in order to wet the entire root zone thoroughly and induce active growth in the vine. Light irrigation of 50 to 75 mm is given once in 10 to 12 days during winter and 5 to 7 days in summer. Irrigation frequency is reduced during and this is fruiting stage and also after berry softening to improve fruit quality. Nutrition. Generally in South India, 600, 1200 of NPK kilogram per hectare is given and North India a dose of 715, 1332 and 1000 kg per hectare is given. The recommended nutrient doses for different varieties of grapes varies from region to region. Special cartridge techniques are available to get quality crop in grapes. First one is the shoot and cluster thinning. Only one or two clusters are retained per cane depending upon the density of the latter. Irrespective of the number of clusters, only the apical two or three shoots are retained. In vines trained to the flat roof cable system, individual shoot length is encouraged rather than the total canopy size for preventing sunburn of the berries. Production of loose clusters. Pre-bloom GA spray of 100 ppm and 15 ppm are given respectively on the 11th to 14th day after bud break for cluster elongation. Ratches of the clusters are trimmed to retain 8 to 10 depending on the number of leaves available per cluster. Clusters are dipped in GA solution of 30 to 40 ppm when 10 to 20% of the flowers open in each cluster for berry thinning. Increasing the berry size. How to increase the berry size for marketing purpose? Manual means are used to supplement chemical thinning to ensure adequate berry thinning and improve the quality of the grapes. Approximately 90 to 120 berries are retained per cluster depending upon the number of leaves available to nourish it at 8 to 10 berries per every leaf depending on its size. Clusters are dipped in GA solution of 40 to 50 ppm concentration once at 3 mm size of the berries and again at 7 to 8 mm of size. When berry diameter is to be increased to more than 16 mm, clusters are dipped in a mixture of 10 ppm of BA, that is benzyl adenine, 25 ppm of GA or 2 ppm of CPPU plus 25 ppm of GA or 1 ppm of brassinosteroid plus 25 ppm of GA instead of GA alone at these stages. In addition to the treatment with growth regulators, berry size and crispness are increased by girdling. The width and depth of girdling are 1 to 1.5 mm. Girdling is done at 4 to 5 mm diameter of the berries. Increasing the TSS content is another important operation wherein berry thinning and cluster thinning to maintain adequate leaf fruit ratio 5 per centimeter square while girdling will ensure a TSS content of 20 degree bricks. Use of plant growth regulators in grapes. Good variety of bunches of grapes for eating quality should be from medium to big sized seedless grains. Varieties like Perlet tend to bear very compact bunches and require considerable thinning of berries for proper development of the berry and bunch. Removal of distal end of the bunches helps in uniform ripening of the berries. Further, application of growth regulators also helps in improving the fruit quality. Application of 20 ppm of gibberellic acid at full bloom followed by dipping of bunches at 75 ppm of GA solution at fruit set stage increases the bunch and berry size of the seedless varieties. Similar kind of treatment given to seeded varieties does not give the same kind of result. Brief bloom application of succinic acid 2,2-dimethylhydrazide, that is SADH 1500 ppm, and chlorocholine chloride, that is CCC 1200 ppm, increases the fruit set and yield in Thompson seedless and Anabshabi cultivars of grapes. Grapes encounter many disorders. Let us see some of them. First one is the insect pest. Insect pest mostly observed are flea beetle, thrips and wasp. For controlling this, spraying with dichlorovas, dimethyote and endosulfan are recommended. In the case of diseases, grape is susceptible to diseases like downy mildew, powdery mildew, black rot, wilt, leaf blight. Timely treatment and control measures are available, which have to be systematically followed to eradicate these diseases. Regarding the disorders which are observed in grapes, especially post-harvest berry drop, berry cracking, leaf chlorosis, dead arm and trunk splitting are commonly encountered in grape production. Maturity indices and harvest. In North India, plants start fruiting after 2 years of planting. Berries start opening from the end of May in early varieties. However, most of the varieties are harvested after they have changed color near the tip and have become sweet. A day prior to picking, the broken, decayed, deformed, undersized fruits are removed. The clusters are usually harvested during the early hours of the day before temperature rises above 20 degrees C. Yield varies according to variety and climatic conditions. The average yield of Anabishagi and Bangalore Blue is 40 to 50 tons per hectare, while that of seedless varieties is 20 tons per hectare. Average yield of 20 to 25 tons per hectare is considered as a good yield in the case of grapes. In respect of post-harvest management, grading is a very important operation, which is mainly done based on the size and color of the grapes to maintain uniformity of the berries in a package. While grading, size of the berry is the criterion, but not the size or shape of the bunch. Pre-cooling is done to reduce the field heat, moisture loss, and subsequently increase the storability of the grapes. Fruit needs to be pre-cooled to a temperature below 4.4 degrees C within 6 hours after harvesting in cold rooms, refrigerator cars, or tunnels. Cooling of grapes is generally carried out in special rooms attached to the cold storage units. Mobile pre-cooling units, that is refrigerated cars, are also in operation to cool the grapes during their transport to the cold storage units situated away from the production site. In respect of storage, the shelf life of grapes is only 1 week at room temperature. The storage life of grapes can be increased by employing suitable means to reduce desiccation, decay due to growth of fungi, especially botrytis, cladosporium, alternaria, etc., and biochemical deterioration. Harvesting the overripe grapes during hot hours of the day, careless handling to cause bruises and injuries to the berries at harvest, packing stages can reduce the storage life of grapes. Under optimum conditions of storage, the maximum storage life of Anabishagi variety is about 40 days, Muscat 45 days, Thompson seedless 30 to 60 days, etc. Ideal condition for storage are low temperature, that is 0 degrees C, and with a humidity of 92 to 96%. Some of the methods recommended for increasing the shelf life of grapes are spraying of fungicides, Kapton 0.2%, Oreofungin 500 ppm, DCNA, that is 2,6-dichloro-4-nitronaline 0.2%, 3 to 4 days before harvest, reduce the decay of berries in storage. Application of growth retardants like NAA 500 ppm, Kinetin 50 ppm before harvest, reduce berry drop during storage. Spraying of growth retardants like B9 2000 ppm, CCC 2000 ppm, LR 500 ppm, malic hydroxide 500 ppm, Phosphon D 500 ppm at harvest or berry softening stage retains the freshness of the grapes for a longer period. Spraying with calcium nitrate, that is 1%, 10 days before harvest reduces the physiological loss in weight. packing, which is a very important operation. Table grapes meant for local market are picked and packed directly in containers in the field. Table grapes meant for long distance markets and for overseas markets are packed differently in the packing shed. Raisin, juice and wine grapes are subjected to suitable treatments and processed. Different types of containers are used for packing grapes in India. Bucket shaped bamboo baskets of 5 kg capacity are common in South India. Wooden boxes, rectangular in shape and capacity to accommodate 5 to 8 kg of fruits are also commonly used. The most commonly used containers are ventilated cardboard boxes of corrugated fiber board, that is CFB, cartons of 2 to 4 kg capacity, which absorbs moisture released by the grapes and provide insulation against minor fluctuations in temperature during cold storage. Table grapes for overseas market are packed in 5-ply corrugated fiber board boxes of 5 kg capacity, printed and labeled attractively. For the European market, bunches of grapes of about 300 to 700 grams are packed in food grade plastic pouches. They are then wrapped in polythene sheets along with grape gourd and tissue paper. Grape gourd is used as per international norms to prevent fungal and bacterial infections to grapes due to moisture, if any. Transportation. Table grapes are mostly transported through roadways for local, short distance or long distance markets. About 5% of the produce is transported by rail and the quality of produce transported through air cargo is almost negligible. The cold chain for grapes is maintained meticulously right from pre-cooling state to selling of the same. The produce for international market is sent through refrigerated vans by road up to the seaport and then again by sea in the refrigerated containers in the ships to their respective destination. Marketing. The producers sell the fruit either to the pre-harvest contractors or to the wholesaler through an agent, with these middlemen sharing profit. Cooperative grape marketing societies are in existence in many grape producing states. The advantage of marketing by producers cooperative are reduction in price gap by avoiding the commission agents and wholesaler, regulate supplies and different markets, minimize the marketing problem arising out of unhealthy competition among the producers. Two channels of selling grapes exist in the international market, namely through producers cooperatives who collect, pack, cool, transport, market it abroad and share the profit with the growers. The second one is through the traders who purchase, pack, pre-cool, store, then ship these in refrigerated containers to the overseas market. While summing up the production of grapes, in India, grapes cultivation is mentioned in old literatures. Grapes belongs to the species Vitis, and in old over, it is grown for wine making, raisin making and table purposes, but predominantly it is for wine making. It is grown in subtropical and tropical conditions with a temperature ranging from 15 to 35 degrees C, soil ranging from sandy to clay soils with a pH of 6.5 to 7.5. There are more than 30 varieties of grapes which are classified based on region, consumption, color and seed. Grapes are multiplied through hardwood cuttings but recently by grafting on selected rootstocks. Spacing generally varies with the varieties and soil fertility from 2 into 3 meter to 6 into 3 meter distance. Right method of pruning is very important for getting highest productivity, and the three types of pruning methods are in work, namely bower system, telephone system and flat roof cable system. Grape requires moderate irrigation but heavier fertilizer dose. Many hormones are used to speed up the growth of the grapes to get maximum yield or to halt their growth for uniform ripening. Grape is prone to be affected by many diseases, pests and disorders which can be controlled by suitable methods. Grape yield about 20 to 25 tons per hectare of fruit. However, good yielders like Bangalore Pro can yield up to 50 tons per hectare.